against the number of citizens that will probably pay that, which is around 1,300. Is that what we're at? We're at about 1,300 folks with households.
Households.
That's about $31 per person, or $2.64 a month, that would be overage that we don't even know we're going to get. If it was $310 a person, I'd be sitting here saying, we're going to lower the spending. If it was $50 a month, I'd probably say, we got to move. We're way over pricing ourselves in this. Now, that's the way I see it. That's my personal view of where I stand on why I would keep the village just like it is and allow the process that it has shown over the last 5 years play itself out, which has been pretty good. It's been pretty good based on our projections, it's based on what we've actually planned.
I can hear
it fully intent.
I concur with everything the council said, and that thought is spot on. That's it. I mean, that's it in a nutshell. Everything that you said is it. And if you look at the trend that AR is setting, just take the water and sewer fees. Not wanting to raise or cause a burden to the citizens would cause that same thing with water and sewer. In this case, your analysis is correct, because it hadn't always been that way. When 3, 4, 5 years ago, when other cities had to triple their millage rates, because, like you said, that level of service that you're talking about and the increased cost to provide that service, millage couldn't cover.
The LISA, 16 out of 20 years rolled back its millage rate consecutively, and was great stewards of that. But the market caught up and had to raise it to 2 mils in 1 year. So that's an example.
That's perfect. We're going to err. I just think we need to err on the side with this amount of money. I think we need to err on the side of making sure that at the end of the year, that I would want to handle the business of the city like I would. I would tell people that work with it, and the coaches and the staffs that manage particular parts of the budgets that I gave them every year. I said, really, you've got to manage this like you would your own checkbook. And make sure at the end of the year, whereas you don't want to be in the red at the end of the year, I want you to manage your budget that way as well. And all this does is it's shown us across the board that even in doing this, we've actually come up about $5,000 a year short in collections of what we rejected. So from that standpoint, I think we're sitting, the fact that our millage is so low, the fact that there may come a time if we can grow this city. I don't want to make it a big time, don't get upset. I don't want to be biased. But if we grow this city and bring quality people to this town, and quality businesses, residents, and we grow this city, then there may come a time when we need them more than that, because the quantity will allow us to do so. But of course, we all know that when you grow your city, more services are required. And so it kind of keeps itself level in that respect. But I am, that's where I sit. Thank you. Appreciate that. Somebody understood what I said.
Man, good luck. Everything you said was good. You can slash anything in a situation. Now, one thing I will take it's not $30 average across the board. There's about 50% of the people who are going to get a tax increase in the city. you should know yourself, you're going to be a heck of a lot more than $30 across the board.
Not me. You're my family.
Your family.
Tremendous.
Yes. So the $30 per average, you can't use that as a talking point, because 50% of the homes are going to have no tax increase at all. The other half, up towards $200,000 homes, or I should say $575,000, are going to get a significant tax increase. So it's going to be a kind of a curve. So the $30, that's can't be said.
And well, but across the board, Ralph, when you are trying to calculate and represent every citizen in this town, I mean, I represent my district, but at the same time, every citizen in this town is looking to us to do something that is as fair and equitable as we possibly can. And so that's why you have to use averages in a lot of cases.
Well, tax
say that
you don't have.
It may hurt this person a little bit more than it hurts that person, but the average out, it all comes out in the wash to, in the end, serve the citizen. In the end, we're not overly burdening our citizens with these types of
things. But don't use, you're going to average it. You average it on what the curve looks like. The curve is about 50%. And, of course, as you go up on the scale of the value of homes, they're going to be hit a lot harder.
Sure. Can I ask something about that?
Well, okay.
If you're done, I'm sorry.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Well, I mentioned that Monday night about the $30 per person or per property owner, which would be a rough average of what the impact would be. And I mentioned that to give a little bit of perspective about what the roughly the impact would be per property owner. And I got that from the 1250 number from our water and sewer services, divided into the $38,700 and whatever dollars it is, comes out to be roughly $31. That when you're making decisions like this, you have to look at some big pictures, and then you have to look at some more specifics, you have to crunch some numbers. You have to compare it and understand what the county's going to do and the city and all these things we've been talking about. So, yeah, that's, in my opinion, that's a very valid point to use the $30 average. Now, you told me something tonight that I didn't know, and you just mentioned it again, and I'm glad you did, that 50% of the property owners in the city will not be affected by this tax that I just increased. Is that correct?
About 50%.
So logically, I don't have to do any numbers or crunch any numbers. That doubles that average to $60. So now we have $60 as an average, and over 90%, I looked and I get that from some numbers that I got from this sheet right here. It gives me a rough idea that from real and personal taxes, 67 million of the 69 million, whatever percentage that is, tells me what's going to come from the average homeowner in town. They're going to bear the brunt of this tax increase, 50% of them anyway. All this information tells me that if there are higher numbers in the millions as opposed to $100,000 to $200,000 homes, then that curve is going to be very slightly tweaked at the top end. That changes that number to $58 average per person. So, and again, I'll concede this. That's not accurate.
No, these are all guesses.
They're guesses and they're estimations. So, and I'll give you that. They're not accurate. But it's a pretty safe bet to say that if we pay somebody to crunch all those numbers, it's going to be within a dollar or two. Say I'm wrong. Within a plus or minus $50. Okay? That's getting to be, the chances of it being outside that range are getting to be pretty astronomical. So we still have a good idea about what the impact is to the individual property owner. That includes business owners or $2 million homeowners or houses in Woodbridge and Lawson Farms and Hodges and Barfield and Price and Circle and all these areas. They all fall in that area. They all fall in that range. So, and I'm not saying that's a small amount of money and something, anything to scoff at. However, what I am saying is that these are estimations, and these these are monies that are, they're estimated that we don't really know we're getting yet. And as such, we have a pretty good idea about if we're completely wrong, what that bottom, and you know, y'all heard me say this before, what's that bottom line risk? That's it. $60, $80, $110 for the entire year of 2016 as a result of the increase of tax digest. And I'm going to say one thing about that word, because Councilman Barfield said something perfect, as far as I'm concerned, and mentioned the grocery store analogy. That ties, and in fact, the word digest, when you hear the word index or digest, that is necessarily tied to the idea of a market value. Market value is a moving number, a sliding scale, and it moves and it changes. So that digest is a direct relation to a market, to a movement in the market. We can't change that. Hayhawer Council has not affected that one bit, and Hayhawer Council cannot. Okay.
Use some of that increase.
My conclusion on that is that there is no tax increase being entertained by the Hayhawer City Council tonight. It's not even a legal option from what I understand. There is no tax increase being made or entertained by the Hayhawer City Council tonight. Let me let that sink in a minute. But the tax, irregardless, most everybody in this room is going to experience a slight tax increase next year because of the tax digest tied to the market set by the tax assessor's office in Lowndes County. Increase has got nothing to do with the Hayhawer Road City Council and taxes. Okay? We understand that now. I understand it's very confusing. I haven't learned a lot more myself this week. I'm not trying to be condescending or flippant. I'm telling you, this is something that's very, it's hard to understand. However, these things have been said straight out. There is no tax increase being entertained for Hayhawer. What we are entertaining is whether to leave the millage rate the same or the tax percentage, as you mentioned, a good analogy, or possibly reducing it. I think that reducing it because is a mistake because of what I mentioned earlier. It's tied to the market. We can't change our rollback, our millage rate, our percentage every time we have some monies. It was mentioned that this is a windfall, and I wouldn't disagree with that. $38,000 is not a small amount of money, but even coming up with that amount of money, we can't just entertain a rollback every time that happens, especially when the worst risk to the average citizen, the worst impact risk, is about $60. I don't think that's a wise thing to do, although I do applaud the idea of rolling back taxes anytime that it's reasonable. I just don't think that at this time it is reasonable.
Ken, I want to make a point, and about what you said, and philosophically what you said about it's not a tax increase. We know that the state of Georgia classifies it as a tax increase.
That's true.
We have to recognize that, and so I'm not going to sit here and say that it's not a tax increase. I would personally say it's not a tax increase. I'm just saying that philosophically, based on, we got to recognize that as the representatives of not only the citizens, but trying to uphold the rules and regulations and policies of the state. Yes, there will be more money collected this year based on assessments. That is classified as a tax increase. But I just want to go back and right on top of what you said is that $31 at the end of the year, if it holds true with the other years, it's going to be $31. It's more than likely going to be much, much less because our history shows that we do not collect what we project. Okay, so even in the $60, if we projected that, if we take the percentage of what we collected and what we audited.
I want to clarify.
Yes, go ahead.
But I just want to clarify, those projections don't come from the city, they come from the tax commission.
That's right.
I'm not sure.
So there are a lot of little factors here that I think we've all talked about here that lead us to believe what we believe. But that's the thing that hits you, after it's all said and done, at the end of the year, I would want everybody that's here tonight to show up for our budgeting next year. And at the end of the year, if we collected it all, let's look at it, let's say, I was right, you were wrong. Because that's when you're going to know what the collections are going to be at the end of the year and what that was.
What's the other side of that?
You made a statement that we lost, we didn't collect 13, 14, and 15. We had 13, we had 3.10%, 1 increase, 3.93, 14, and 13.32 increase.
And you're referring to the estimation? Those are the estimations of the tax commissioner's office.
Yeah, but the last one.
That's not actual estimations. No, those are estimations from the tax commissioner's office.
The 3.1?
Yes, sir.
That's not a balance figure.
All the estimations.
All the 5-year printout that we.
I thought they
sent you that email.
They don't have any of our audited figures.
I thought these were.
No, those are projections.
Well, I know 10, 11, and 12 is when this country went into recession, or whatever you want to call it.
The recession was 7, 8, 9.
Well,
we were getting out of it by 10.
But the 10, we were still hurting the city.
Well, sure.
But, still you know, ad valorem taxes, if these things are their estimates, ad valorem taxes, that's like the death tax. I mean, when you die, you're going to pay it. Ad valorem taxes, even if somebody's home is taken away from, somebody's going to pay that tax.
Right.
So ad valorem taxes don't go up and down. So if they set a house at a particular ad valorem tax value, the city's going to collect that at the end of the year or somewhere. So ad valorem tax, ad valorem taxes.
That's if it changes hands.
Well, even if the bank has it, they have to pay the tax. Somebody's going to pay the tax at the end of the year on every piece of property in the city. Period. And, you know.
But we have to know that for some reason, the amount that was projected by the county didn't end up in our audited figures being the amount we got in the bank.
Well.
Why is that the case?
I understand that. You know, everything is projections, you still, if they say, if the county says that piece of property is valued at a certain value, and a certain amount of taxes due on that, somebody, be it a bank, the homeowner, somebody's going to pay that every year, every December, that's going to be.
I could agree with that, but still we have a difference in what is projected and what is collected.
Projection is easy, and I asked the commission, we'll get this dragged out too much.
I don't.
The tax commission office adds up all of the values.
Right.
And they said, okay, that it probably won't change. I asked her, I said, how much will that change? She said 1-2%. I mean, that's nothing.
Sure.
So
you got some properties that go into default, and you could tie up the paying of those taxes for several years. I'm not sure you're on them.
Oh, yes.
You could have several pieces of property in your county.
Go
under default or go bankrupt, that's people leave. And it takes a while. You don't collect it that year. It's going to probably take a while to get that. And that's why there's probably delay.
There's not that much. You make it sound like there's a big difference. We could have a big swing in that.
You can. You can. Based on these numbers, projected and collected, there have been numbers. 20,000 over the last 5 years.
I'd have to look at those numbers. I have not seen those.
Okay,
we talked as much.
You should have got that email.
Well, I haven't been home. I've been down.
Yesterday.
No, I didn't. I haven't even looked at my computer. Just yesterday afternoon.
All right. Sounds to me like y'all covered pretty much every angle there is. It doesn't really leave me a whole lot to.
I'm sorry.
do know y'all were talking on the projections and all on the residents, 50%, and then going from 50% of the residents and so forth and so on. But people that have received a new tax bill increase, it might have been businesses. The calls that I have had, every one of them was a business. And theirs had went up 100% or more. And as far as I know, everyone that I've talked to and the ones that they've talked to that have went up, every one of them is going to be an appeal. So you're talking $38,000 on what they're projecting HEHOLA to get. They're not telling you about how much, about what percentage of that is going to be in appeals that you may never see. You may never see. And I'm not one for spending money before I have it in my hand. I don't like to spend money unless I know for sure it's sitting in my hand or in my bank account. I don't like to say Ms. Roosevelt, but yes, I did say I would not raise taxes. And I won't raise taxes. I will not recommend a tax increase on our millage rate for the city of HEHOLA as long as I'm sitting. Matter of fact, I was in a meeting today with a citizen of HEHOLA. He came up to see me. Councilman Davis happened to be there. And I told him the exact same thing that I said the night we had a forum, that I would not raise taxes. And I told him there was not one council member on the board that would vote to raise taxes. But I do not consider this a tax increase for the city of HEHOLA. I just see this is a digest increase that they are projecting. And to me, your projection, particular projection, is not saying I'm going to get this money. It's like y'all been saying all night long. It's an estimate. It's a guessing game. And I don't believe it will be $30. I don't believe it will be $50 for household. Because like I say, from what the phone calls I've had, it's all mainly been businesses. There are some residents. I think I just found that out. But as far as your average household, I haven't had a complaint or a call against it, wanting to know why my taxes are going up. What has the city done? So, if there is no more discussion at this time, I will entertain a motion.
Go ahead. I make a motion that we leave the millage rate at 4.75 that's historically last few years.
I have a motion by Councilman Benjamin to leave the millage rate at 4.75. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Councilman Barfield. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Like sign.
Aye.
Motion carried. At this time, I need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.